Dieter Waizenegger, thank you to be with us today.
Sure, thank you.
You're the director of SEIU. I would like to know why a trade union like yours choose to use shareholder activism to challenge companies like Sodexo about the respect of trade unions' rights in the US.
Okay. So our members participate in public pension funds and private pension funds in the United States. Those pension funds are invested in many, many companies in the United States, but also globally, including Sodexo. We believe that companies have to apply with not only local laws, but also with their own principles that they have signed up, such as Sodexo signed up to the UN Global Compact. That states clearly states that the company is planning and wants to adhere to global labor rights, which includes the workers' freedom of association. Now, we have ample evidence that the company is violating workers' freedom of association around the globe, in the Dominican Republic, in Colombia, but also in Turkey and the United States. So we believe the company should sign a global agreement with a global union federation, the IUF, to use it as a tool to manage its social performance around the world.
Your campaign was launched more than 1 year ago. What result did you get?
So far, we got the company's attention, and we believe that the company is thinking about it. However, we discovered as we were looking around the globe into the company's record many, many problems. So yet unresolved. But I think it's more and more investors are getting interested in this issue and are looking into the record because it is a reputational risk, and a company that does business globally is faced with lots of regulatory and regimes, and it needs to operate under these regimes, and having a good reputation is very important to attract new business. So I think the company needs to manage its labor rights risks to really improve its reputation globally.
Do you think that shareholder activism is a general way for trade union in Europe and especially in France?
So I think my clear answer to this is it depends. Trade unions have members in funded pension schemes, as they say in the UK, or pension funds in the US, I think trade unions should think about how they use that money that is really workers' capital and how they position themselves in the capital market as responsible and sustainable investors. So if trade unions decide to do that, yes, I think it's a very legitimate tool. And I think a number of trade unions are thinking about this, how to use this money because that the members have invested in. In many parts of Europe, it's relatively new, such as here in France. So I think it's still a very legitimate and very good debate of how trade unions should relate to that money.
Maybe last question about the crisis. It's a big, huge crisis. How will move our strategy, or what are you expecting after the crisis?
So I think it was a wake-up call for everyone. It showed the markets cannot just go up again. There were some good regulatory initiatives, however, they fell a little bit short. So I think now it's time for investors to step in and assert their role to make sure that companies behave responsible and actually adopt practices that make the companies more sustainable and successful over the long term. So I believe there are a number of shareholders in Europe who are very much planning and are already engaged in this project of making companies more responsible. So I think it was a good call, many investors are taking up the challenge.
Thank you, Dieter Waizenegger, to have been with us today.
Okay, thank you.